OpenAI has released its Assistants API some time back. The Assistants API allows you to build AI assistants with your own applications. So I wanted to create a data scientist assistant to analyze some data. So in this video, with the help of a collab notebook, I'll explain how you can create a data scientist assistant, okay, data scientist AI assistant, using the Assistants API to analyze a data set. Now the data set is this particular data set from Kaggle, which is data science salaries 2023, salaries of different data science fields in the data science domain. So this is a CSV file, okay, so which has these various fields like work year, experience level, employment type, job title, salary, and so on. So I want to create an assistant who will actually analyze this data set for me and give some responses based on this data. So for this, what I have to do is that I require an API key. So I create my API key on, the OpenAI here API keys are present. So I can create an API key. So this is my OpenAI API key, which I have created. Okay. Then if you look at assistants, what is the idea over here? The idea here is that we create an assistant in the API by defining its custom instructions and picking a model. And if helpful, we'll also enable some tools like code interpreter, retrieval, and function calling. So once an assistant is created, then we need to create a thread for starting a conversation. Then we need to add messages to the thread. This is when the user asks the questions. And then we run the assistant on the thread to trigger responses. This will automatically call the relevant tools. That is the idea over here. Okay, so let's go to our collab notebook. So what I will do is that I install OpenAI over here. Let me zoom in a little bit. Okay, so I install OpenAI over here. I have downloaded this Kaggle file, this CSV file, and I've uploaded it over here under a folder called data dssalaries.csv. Okay, then what I do over here is that I install OpenAI library, then I have to import OpenAI, I have to create a client. Okay, to the client I set my API key over here. Okay, so once I've set this API key, then I can upload some file. Okay, so basically I have to upload this file because I want to do analysis on this file, right? So here I am uploading this file, and the purpose is that for Assistants API to make use of this file. So this is how I upload this file. Okay, then comes the main this thing where we are creating our assistant. So we can create assistant like this, client.beta.assistants.create. The name is data analyst, or say data scientist assistant, something like that. That is the name. So the instruction I am putting over here is that you are a data analyst, perform data analysis and create visualization on the uploaded CSV file. Okay, why did I mention CSV file over here? Because when I was experimenting, when I did not mention this CSV file, it was not able to pick up this format for some reason. So I thought I'll put it in the instruction itself. So it was asking in the response that can you specify the file type and so on. So I just put that over here. And the tool which I want to make use of is code interpreter, because code interpreter has the functionality to execute Python code. I want to do some calculations on this, CSV file. So I want to do some calculations on the salary field and so on. So I would want to make use of the code interpreter tool. And the model over here is GPT-4 Turbo. Okay. And the file, I am going to make use of these files. So the file is uploaded. There is a file ID returned. So that file ID I'm using over here. So that is the idea over here. Okay. Now the model could be GPT-3.5 Turbo also, right? You can try out with different models over here. Okay. But I'm not sure if some models are not supported in the Assistants API. That is something which we need to check over here. Okay. So what do I do next? Okay, so once I create this assistant, there is an ID created over here. There is a time. Okay, there is a description. There is a file ID. All these things are given over here. Now, if you go to your OpenAI dashboard and if you click on assistants, right, you can actually see this assistant which has been created. Okay, so this is the data analyst assistant. So now if you open it, it says the instruction, it says the model which is being used. Okay, it also tells which are the tools which have been enabled. Okay, so I have not enabled function calling, not enabled retrieval, but I have enabled code interpreter over here and the file which has been uploaded. Okay, now with this thing created over here, I can go over here and test it as well. Okay, so basically I can put a message over here saying that, you know, I can test it, right? I want to I'll say what are the different job roles. Okay, let's see what happens. Basically, I want to look, you know, what are the different job titles basically. Let me see what is the response over here. I'm not sure what kind of response comes over here. So it says the instruction comes over here. You are a data analyst, perform data analyst and create visualizations of the load files. It is actually running. In the meanwhile, let's go back to our code over here. Right. So then I create a thread over here. And when I print the thread, there is a thread ID, there is a created time and so on. Then I need to create a message. Okay, so this is the first user query. So the user query over here is, I want to know what is the average salary of a principal data scientist in US. So this is how I am creating a message, right? And this message should be attached to this thread. That is why thread ID I am specifying over here as this thread.id. Okay, so in this way, I am able to create a message and add it to the thread. I can also get the list of all messages in this thread. So I can get client.beta.thread.messages.list thread ID and I can get the messages over here. So here it shows that particular message, right? What is the average salary for principal data scientist in the US, right? Then what I can do is that I need to create a run. Okay. So here I have to specify the thread ID and the assistant ID. So this creates a run and it starts running on this particular query. Over here it says that it tries to identify if, you know, it needs to make use of the data or not, and other things are decided over here. Okay. Whether it needs to call tools or it can simply use the model to best answer the query. So the assistant decides over here. That is the idea over here. So this is how you are creating a run. Okay. The assistant will also automatically decide what previous messages to include in the context window for the model and so on. Okay. You can also pass new instructions over here in this run. Okay. But these instructions will override the default instructions of the assistant which has been previously present. Okay. So once you create a run, it will go into a queued state. And then you need to periodically retrieve the run to check the status if it has moved to completed to get the response. Okay. So once you do that, it will actually say it is in progress. So you can retrieve the status to check if it is completed. For that, what you can do is that you can put in a simple while loop and you can say that, you know, run whatever run which you have created, you are creating a run over here. If run status is completed, then get the result out of it from the messages, from the latest message, right? So that is what I am doing over here. And, you know, it gives this response saying that the average salary of a principal data scientist in the US is this number. So it is actually computed and it is given. Okay. So then you can print the messages just to see. So it prints the list of messages over here, right? And here you can see other intermediate messages also, like, you know, how it has been computed and so on. Okay. Those things are also present over here, right? So now let's go back to our playground to see if what it has pulled out. Okay, so it has actually pulled out from that particular, you know, how it has done, right? It is using the code interpreter. So it seems there was an issue with the loading the data or finding this thing. Then it will try some other method. Then it has loaded the data. And from the data, it is actually pulled that these are the various roles, okay, which are available in this particular column, which is job title. So it is able to understand that and it is actually giving me this output, okay? So now what else can you do actually over here? So what I've done is that I've created a simple Gradio interface. Okay. And for some reason, the Gradio latest version was throwing a bug. So then I found out that this version is better. So I used this particular version. And then what I did was that I created a predict function, which takes input from the Gradio interface, which is your query, along with the history. Then I create that input as part of the message. Okay. Attach it to the same thread. Create a run, And then I wait for the run status to be completed. Once the run status is completed, I retrieve the response and I return it. So this is my predict function. Now all I have to do is that I have to import from Gradio the chat interface, pass this predict function and launch the user interface with share is equal to true because I want to create a public URL, and debug is equal to true because if any errors are there, I want to check it out. So in that way, I have actually created this particular interface. And here I am asking like, what is the average salary of a data scientist in Europe? It actually computes that and says that this is the approximately this particular number based on this data set, but it could be different. Okay. Please note that this is the average based on the data available in the data set. Okay. Now we can actually ask this question again in our interface. Let me go to the playground and let me paste it. Okay. Probably in the previous message, it said that, it couldn't identify the format. So let me specify over here. And let me run this. Now this will take some time to run. So it again makes use of code interpreter to read the file, to understand which column, execute that code and compute. Okay. So in a similar way, I again ask this question after this particular response, what are the various titles present in this data set? Actually, it has actually pulled this particular response. Now we can try other things also over here, like, what is the percentage of experience level, or let's see if there are some other columns over here. Work year, job title, salary, salary in USD, employee residence. Okay, then we can put a question like, from which countries have people responded? Okay, responded in this data set. Now, this is also going to get queued. Okay, let's see how much time it takes. Probably 30 seconds or something it takes for the response. In the meanwhile, let's see if it has computed over here. So it is actually computed over here, right? And if you go over here and see the details, assuming that the salary is in USD, represents the standard salary across different currencies, we'll use the column to compute the average salaries for data scientists in Europe. The job title column contains the job roles, and in the employee residence may indicate the location which we use to filter for Europe. And then based on that, this thing, so we'll pull up the data scientist, we'll pull up these European countries, and based on the employee residence is in European countries, they make use of that and then compute the average salary. Okay, this is how the computation is done. This particular column dot mean filtered based on this, right? And it is actually pulled out this value. Okay, so in this way it is actually done this particular analysis. I'm just trying to see if the residence column, how does it look over here? US employee residence, but for Europe, how did it pull it? Europe GB, you have others. Okay, so it has actually pulled based on that, right? Yeah, you have other countries also which are present over here. So based on that, it has pulled out from which matches Europe, and it has actually done this particular computation over here. Now let's see if this response is there. Yeah, it has pulled out, say, people from the following countries have responded in the data set: Spain, United States, Canada, Germany, Switzerland, all these things. Okay, so using assistants API, you can now have your data science assistant for you to do your analysis on data. Probably somebody who has no idea of data science also can make use of this API to analyze some data, but then you need to verify for, what is the kind of results which are coming out of it, because this is a large language model again, which is running behind and, behind the scenes, and maybe the results are not accurate. But this video is just about how you can create a custom chatbot on your custom data using the assistants API. I hope this video is useful to you. If you like the video, please like, share, subscribe to the channel. I'll be sharing this notebook in the description of the video, along with the links to the assistants API and the Kaggle dataset. See you in another video.